So, dear students, today we are going to do a very beautiful poem, Rain on the Roof. See, it's rainy season. Okay, rainy season is going on. So, you all will enjoy this poem. Okay, see, now you can have a very good experience of this thing. We all are experiencing rain. Okay, you just try to hear the sound of rain. You just try to hear the sound of rain falling. Okay? Don't you feel that this is a very soothing sound? It is having a very healing power. Okay? Tell me, how many of you say that this sound is very healing sound? It is very soothing. How many of you say? Show me thumbs up. Those who think that this sound of rain, that is a very healing sound. Okay, because you just after this class, I just want to tell that you just do one that task. You sit by the window of your house, you try to listen the beautiful sound of rain, and you try to recollect the memories of past. Then you will be able to enjoy the beauty of the poem in a real sense, because through this poem, what does the poet want to tell us? That this rain really has a healing power, okay? And he says that when we are living and sleeping so comfortably in a rainy night, and then this tinkle of rain brings, you can say, dreamy fancies. And he is able to recollect all the memories from his past. Okay? So that's why the rain is considered as an instrument of beautiful memories. Okay? So here the poet recalls the memory of his childhood, of his mother. So we will come to know when we will go through all the stanza. Okay? So you all should have a pencil in your hands. There are so many details that I'm going to tell you about this poem. You just jot down all the details side by side. But first of all, let's read very first paragraph of this poem. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Okay? So here, what does the poet want to say? It means when the humid shadows hover. Okay, bachche, write down the meaning of humid shadows. What is humid shadows? Can anybody tell me? What is humid shadows? Tell me. Humid shadows means? Yes, clouds. Okay, and hover. What is the meaning of hover? It means hang. You jot down the meanings, only then you can enjoy the beauty of the poem. I'll be explaining you each and every line in detail. Starry spheres. Starry spheres. What is the meaning of that? It means stars. Okay. Melancholy. What is the melancholy? Melancholy means sad. Yes, bliss. Bliss means joy, utmost joy, very much happy. And cottage chamber. Cottage chamber means room in a cottage. Room in a cottage. So, bachche, as I'm typing in front of you, you also write down using a pencil on your books. Okay? Because there are so many difficult words. Patter. Patter means sound of rain. Sound of rain falling on the roof. Falling on the roof. Are you writing side by side? I can ask any of the child to show me their books. And overhead. Overhead here means above. Okay. So shall I start the explanation if you have written the meanings? So here in this beautiful stanza, just notice the last words of every line. Hovers, fears, darkness, tears, pillow, bed, patter, overhead. You just try to find out the rhyme scheme of this poem. Are you able to find out the rhyming words and rhyme scheme? Tell me, which are the rhyming words in first stanza? Which are the rhyming words in first stanza? Tell me. Type in chat box. What are the rhyming words? Hurry up. Type in chat box. Let me read what you have written. Okay, spheres and tears appear. Okay, all these are rhyming words. Okay, so with the help of these rhyming words, find out rhyme scheme also. Underline last words and tell me rhyme scheme. Which rhyme scheme are you able to frame? Hurry up, let me find out who is doing their duty well, who are writing side by side. So what will be the rhyme scheme? A, B, C, D, because hover, spheres, darkness, tears, spheres, tears, B and B, both are matching, hover and sphere, both are not matching. So what will be the rhyme scheme here? Tell me, what will be the rhyme scheme? What will be the rhyme scheme of first four lines we find out? A, okay, B, then C, then B. Okay. So, bachche, now try to understand the meaning of the first stanza. Very beautiful, very unique meaning is given here. Listen carefully. Over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness, gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. So here the poet is saying that in the sky, stars are not visible. Why so? Because of clouds, because of humid shadows. It means because of clouds, stars are not visible at all because all of the sky is covered with clouds. And in this darkness, in this sad darkness, there is a rain, okay? And this rain, it seems that this rain is showing its emotions in the form of tears. It means there is a sadness around us. Clouds are looking so sad. In that darkness, the rain, it is raining, and rain is seeming just like a mirror because it is showing its emotion, and it looks as tears are falling softly from human eyes. As when we become sad, what happens? Tears start rolling from our eyes. Okay, so same like that, the poet is saying there is a complete darkness. The environment is very much, you can say, sad. So in that environment, it seems that as from human eyes tears come out, same like that rain is also crying, it is weeping. Okay, so one thing only is that it can bring joy to the poet, that is that he wanted to curl up with a pillow in the bed, okay, and he wants to sit in a room in his cottage. And see, this room can be so small, it can be ill-equipped, but the sound of that raindrops can enable him to recover from sad and gloomy mood. It means he is feeling so sad, he is feeling so depressed, gloomy. What is the, you can say, condition of poet here? What is his status at that time? How is he feeling? Poet is feeling so gloomy. he is feeling so depressed, but there is only one thing that can take out from him from that thing, that is his pillow in the bed. Okay, why so pillow in the bed? Because with the help of this pillow he can recover from his sad and gloomy mood. He can recover from his gloomy mood. Okay, so this is all about first tantra. I'm going to tell you again. See, when the humid shadows means clouds, that whole of the sky is covered with clouds, okay, and stars are not visible at all, and there is a complete sadness, it is a depressing moment, okay, and it seems that rainy tears are weeping. It means full of the environment is so gloomy, and rain also seems that it is showing its emotions. So there will be a one bliss, that will be a one joyful moment. What will be that? The poet who is sitting in the room in his cottage, and in that cottage he wants to, you can say, he wants to enable himself to recover himself from that sad and gloomy mood, okay, by keeping himself on the pillow. Okay, clear? Now I'm going to clear this. Now let's move to second stanza. In second stanza, what does the poet wants to say? What does the poet want to say? Listen carefully. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart, and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start, and a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. So here in this beautiful stanza, what are the rhyming words? Shingles, heart, fancies, start, recollection, woof, patter, roof. Now what are the rhyming words? Type in chat box. What are the rhyming words? Hurry up. What are the rhyming words here? Type in chat box. Okay, very good, Jayati. Heart, start. Okay. Heart and start. Two rhyming words are there. Woof and roof. That is also a rhyming word. So with the help of these rhyming words, what will be the rhyming scheme? Yes, woof, roof, heart, start. So these are the rhyming words. So what will be the rhyming scheme? What will be the rhyming scheme here? Yes, AB, CB. Yes, same rhyme scheme. So bachche, to understand the meaning of this, so write down the difficult meanings. The meaning of tinkle. What is the meaning of tinkle? It means ringing sound. Bachche, again and again I'm telling you, you write down the meanings of difficult words, only then you can understand the meanings. After that, shingles. What is the meaning of shingles? What is the meaning of shingles? Shingles means, yes, tiles used for sloping roof. Yes, these are basically tiles used for sloping roof. Okay. After that, echo. That creates a sound. Okay. After that, air threads. What is the meaning of air threads here? Air threads means dreamy memories. Yes. Dreamy memories. Okay. And into woof. What is the meaning of into woof? Become entwined. Yes. So, bachche, now try to understand the meaning of this stanza. But before that, you have to write down the meanings of these difficult words. Okay. So in this stanza, the poet is describing that how the raindrops make a, you can say, very beautiful, very ringing sound. Okay. Because when these raindrops, when they fall on the tiles, you can also experience, you can listen the sound. Now it is raining, you can see it creates a very beautiful sound. But when these raindrops, when they fall on the roof, on the shingles, on the tiles of the roof, and this roof is sloping, so it makes a very beautiful, very soothing sound. And this sound made by the rain, it is repeated again and again by the beating of his heart. Okay, as there is an echo in our heart, so same like that, this it keeps on repeating and repeating. And you just listen to the heartbeat, it keeps on repeating the same sound again and again. Its sound is not changed. So same like that, the beats of rains are creating the same sound. It is producing a same sound. And with the same sound, here the poet is imagining what imagination is going before his eyes. See, what kind of, when he listened to the soft and continuous falling of the raindrops on his roof, so what comes in front of him? Very beautiful memories. Okay? And these memories, he is able to recall all those memories, and these memories are not separated. Okay? Because these memories have framed a patchwork. So these dreamy memories are being recollected, and these are interwoven. Okay? And these are, you can say, going to recall in front of him. So these memories are too much in number, they are large in number, and all these memories have created a web, have created a cluster in his mind. It means when he is able to, when he is listening the sound of that raindrop, so there is an echo in his heart, as in echo, the heartbeat keeps on repeating. So same like that, he is imagining now, he is listening to the soft and continuous falling of the raindrop on his roof, and all his memories are coming back to him. But these memories are not separated from each other. Instead, these memories have formed a patchwork by becoming intertwined with one another. Okay, so these memories are too much in number, they are large in number, and it has created a cluster in his head. It has created a cluster in his head. Clear? Dhiren, keep your video on, then I will give you a chance to speak. What do you want to say? Yes. Now, what do you want to ask?
Ma'am, I want to ask that which type of memories are these?
Past memories. What happened with him? Okay, what happened with him? There was a collection of different kind of memories about his childhood, about his past. All these memories start accumulating in his mind, and he is able to recall them. Okay? Clear? Because he is in a very sad mood, gloomy mood. So whenever he listens such kind of soothing sound of rain, so many types of memories come in his mind. Okay? Now in next stanza, you will come to know that which kind of memory is occurring in his mind. Okay? So let's read third paragraph. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers, or she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Okay, so bachche, write down the meanings of these lines, these words. Then I will be explaining you each and every line of third stanza. So right now, in memory comes. In memory comes, it means I remember. Okay? I remember. I remember agone. What is the meaning of agone? Yes. Gone by. Agone means gone by. And here, what is the meaning of regard? Regard means to observe. Observe. Okay. The darling dreamers. The darling dreamers. The darling dreamers means her sleeping children. Her sleeping children. Okay. Bachche, write down meanings, only then you will be able to understand the beauty of the poem. Otherwise, you can't enjoy this poem because meaning will not be clear to you. But if you write down the meanings, it will be easy for you to understand. See here, according to this stanza list, what is the meaning of list? Here, according to this stanza list means listen. Okay? So here, refrain. What is the meaning of refrain? Refrain here means part of the song that is repeated. Part of the song. Part of the song that is repeated. Okay? And the last meaning we have is played upon. Played upon. It means the sound coming due to rain. Coming due to rain. I think today was the appropriate day to enjoy this poem, isn't it? Because we can experience it. Now, bachche, I have written the meanings of difficult words. Now, let's enjoy the meaning of this stanza. Now, in memory comes my mother. Now, here, in this stanza, the poet describes the very first memory that he can actually identify. Okay, because there is a cluster of so many memories in his mind. There is a patchwork. There are so many memories in his mind. But now he remembers the memories of his childhood. Okay, which kind of memory? When his mother used to look at him and his brothers and sister, because brother and sisters, they all were sleeping together and they all were having beautiful dreams. Okay, so his mother would make a point to look at them every night. Okay, and she knew that she would not see them again till the next morning. Okay, so his mother would bend down and watch over him in a particular. So these memories are being recalled. Why so? Because when he listened to the repetitive sounds of rain, so which kind of memories come in his mind? The memories of his childhood, when he used to sleep along with his brother and sister, and their mother was with them. Okay. So such kind of memories are being recalled. Okay. So in third paragraph, here the poet is saying that his mind is full of memories. There is a cluster of memory. There is a patchwork of memory. But now he is able to recall all those agone. Agone means all those days which are gone by. Which days are gone by? Childhood days. Okay. Here, the poet is able to recall the memories of his childhood when he used to sleep with his brother and sister. Okay. It was a time of night. Brother and sister, they were sleeping together and mother was with them to look after them. Till morning, mother was with them. Okay. And with lots of fond. Fond means with lots of love. She used to look after her parents, look after her children. Okay. And as I list to this refrain, list to, it means whenever I listen to this refrain, refrain means whenever I listen to this repeating sound of rain. Because which kind of repeating sound? That the sound of rain which is falling on the sloping of roof. So it is creating a pattern, it is creating a same sound, rhythmic sound. So this sound, because of this sound, he is able to recall his past memories. He is able to recall those beautiful days when he was sleeping so soundly along with his brother and sister, siblings, and mother was with them. Mother was with them. So it was a soothing time of their life. So poet is able to recall that soothing chime. Okay. So this was all about third stanza. I will tell you all the poetic devices which are used in this poem in detail. Okay. Because it will take so many days to cover up this poem. But this poem is so beautiful. I really enjoy teaching you this poem. Did you enjoy this poem? In such kind of environment, did you enjoy this poem? Dhiren is saying to me, please explain first paragraph again. First paragraph is not clear to you? See, in this first paragraph, what does the poet want to say? See, basically, what is the gist of the poem? The gist of the poem is that there is a complete sadness. Depressing moments are there. And because of the shadows, the clouds, the sky, you can say, stars are not visible. There is a complete sadness, darkness. And it seems that it is not, rain is not falling. It seems that somebody is crying, somebody is weeping in the form of rain tears. Okay. So here the poet feels that this is the happiest moment for him. This is the, you can say, bliss for him, that if he goes inside his room and he takes a pillow and he puts himself in that pillow, okay, and he listens to the sound of that raindrops which are falling on the ceiling, which is falling on the roof. And these raindrops are falling consecutive. It is making same sound again and again. Okay. And in such kind of environment, he is able to recall about his past memories. Which kind of memories? Very soothing memories. When he was feeling so cozy, when he was feeling so comfortable in the company of his siblings, brother and sisters, mother was also with them to look after them. So he is able to recall all those memories in such kind of environment. And these raindrops are creating a continuous sound. Okay. And this continuous sound is making him recall about all his past memories of his childhood. When mother was showing her gentle love to her children. To her children. Okay. So the poet says it was so soothing, it was so pleasant to live and sleep comfortably in a cottage on a rainy night. It means when he listened to this kind of sound, he is able to recall the time of his childhood when it was raining and very in a very cozy environment, in a very comfortable environment, he was in the company of his mother and his sibling. So such kind of past memories are fresh in his mind now. Okay. But now his life is quite different. His life is changed. Life of poet is completely changed. So it is basically given in the poem. So in this poem, different kind of poetic devices are used. So the very first device that is used is refrain. Okay. Why refrain? Refrain because there is a group of words which is repeated throughout the poem. Which word is being, which phrase is repeated? Tell me. Type in chat box, tell me which phrase is being repeated in the poem again and again. and you find out this again and again in the poem. Tell me what is that? Type in chat box. Hurry up. Which is being repeated? Who is going to type in chat box? Only one? Only Jayati has written? What about others? See, at the end of each stanza, pattern of the rain is repeated or not? You read this poem thoroughly again. Tell me which phrase is being repeated. So here is a phrase, is a group of words which is being repeated again and again throughout a poem. And this is patter of the rain. So which poetic device is used here? Tell me which poetic device is used here? Yes, very good. Refrain. Why refrain? Because a group of words is being repeated. A group of words is being repeated again and again. You can write down all the details in your books. We will continue this poem tomorrow also. Okay? And if you face any kind of difficulty, if any of the line is not clear, you can ask me. And I really want to appreciate all those students, those who have participated yesterday in 9th English group. I ask you to participate for Yuva. You sent me very beautiful poems and your all poems are being uploaded. So keep it up. Keep on participating like this. Okay? Okay, students. Thank you and have a nice day.